So we've all been there. You've been at your desk typing away an email or working on a project or watching a movie or just simply doing something that you don't want to stop. And all of a sudden you get that urge, that sudden desire to go to the bathroom. And what do? Well, some of us will stop what we're doing and go to the bathroom. And others of us will keep doing what we're doing and say, hey, hold on, we'll go in a couple minutes when we're done with this particular thing we're working on. So is that gonna create a problem if you hold your urine for too long? What if you do it all the time? Are you one of those people who has a bladder like a racehorse and you never have to go to the bathroom? Is that a badge of honor that you're wearing? Well, I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today I'm going to explain what happens when you hold your pee for too long and how that can affect your health. So what happens when your bladder is filling? Normally, your bladder is like a balloon, and you take in fluids, and your body is then circulating those fluids into your body and in through your kidneys. The urine then goes down your ureters and into your bladder. And your bladder is constantly filling. And so what happens as it fills, normally for the first about 3 to 6 ounces or 100 to 200 mls, you really won't notice a whole lot of anything going on. Then you might notice that there's something in your bladder, like, okay, I feel like there's some urine there and I could go if I wanted to. And then at about 10 to 20 ounces or 300 to 600 mls, you start feeling the urge to go to the bathroom. And that's just normal bladder function. That's what happens. And the way this happens is that your bladder has these receptors on the wall that are called stretch receptors. And as the bladder fills, these stretch receptors signals to your brain. And when they hit a certain point, your brain knows, hey, it's time to go. But you all know that you can, if you have a normal neurologic system, you can postpone going to the bathroom and your brain can say, hold off, and you can tighten your sphincter and avoid urine from coming out. So what's the big deal, right? So what if I do this all the time? Is it really gonna harm me? Well, if you're doing it once in a while, it's probably not gonna be a huge problem. But over time, the signals from your bladder to your brain can change and your brain can start thinking that your bladder is able to hold more and more fluid. So your capacity is larger. Again, in and of itself, not a horrible problem. But once you have a stretched out bladder, the muscles in the bladder wall can get weaker over time. And when they get weaker over time, when you go to the bathroom to empty, you might notice that you're not able to empty everything that's in your bladder. You might feel like, hey, there's something still in there. And subsequently, you might start noticing that you really have to go a lot sooner than you meant to before. And in very extreme circumstances, and I definitely have seen this, particularly in people who work in high stress environments where they can't really leave their job, like hairdressers, teachers, nurses, surgeons like myself, who tend to hold their urine for long periods of time, they can actually stop squeezing their bladder altogether. And what happens? Well, one, if you can't squeeze at all and you can't empty your urine at all, you'll need to catheterize yourself to empty your bladder. Now, I know that sounds horrible. It definitely is a huge change in life and something that people don't want to deal with. Another thing that can happen is you can start getting bladder infections. And when you get bladder infections, you might notice that you're having pain when you urinate, you get that urge more and more often, and you're rushing to the bathroom, and when you get there, only a little bit is coming out. And these can be really painful and really annoying. And that's because all that urine that you're leaving behind is now food for bacteria to eat. And that bacteria is just having a buffet because your bladder is never empty. Conversely, the other thing that can happen is if you're constantly tightening the sphincter and holding your urine in, you can get what's called a high tone pelvic floor. I talk about this all the time, so if you've been following me for a long time, you've probably heard this before. But when you get a high tone pelvic floor, what is that? Well, underneath your bladder is a bowl of muscles that hold up that bladder and all the organs in your body that are down there, so your rectum, your bladder, and in women, your uterus. And these muscles, when they're clenched all the time, they can become hyperactive. And what happens then is that these muscles can cause a lot of symptoms because they're not relaxing. It's just as if you were constantly flexing your arm and you never relaxed. Eventually, this arm would start hurting. And so in some cases, you might notice that you have pelvic pain. So for women, they might see vaginal pain, and for men, you might feel pain in the testicles or in the penis. And you can also get back pain, and you can get symptoms in your bladder. Those can be more urgency, more frequency, and you're running to the bathroom all the time with the urge, gotta go, gotta go. And sometimes you might even leak urine. Also, you might notice some constipation because those muscles are also clenching your anus closed, and so it's harder for you to push out that stool through that clenched muscle. So bottom line, if you need to hold it once in a while, that's probably okay. But if you're one of those people who holds it all the time with that bladder of a racehorse, you might wanna stop. You might wanna start acknowledging that urge when you feel it and actually going to the bathroom. Start prioritizing your health and make sure that you make time to do a normal body function, which is going to the bathroom. So whatever it is, put a timer on your phone. If you don't get that sensation for 12 hours, you should probably be going at least every 4 hours. So put a timer on your phone for every 4 hours and make sure you go to the bathroom when that timer goes off. And when you go, if you're not emptying completely, make sure you sit down, relax on the toilet. Don't hover because that also clenches those pelvic floor muscles. So sit on the toilet. Make sure you relax and empty your bladder completely. If you're not sure, stand up, walk around the bathroom, sit back down, and go again for a second time. Don't strain or push it out, but definitely try to just relax and let the urine come out. All right, I hope that was helpful for you. If you like my channel, please remember to subscribe. And as always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.